Your stuff is too expensive.
Okay, so don't buy it.
I could get something really similar at this other place for way less.
Hey, you're welcome to do that. No problem.
You don't understand. I'm not going to buy it from you because it's way too expensive.
I mean, that's cool. I've got these folks over here. They're cool with the price, so I'm all right. You go ahead and you can go pick it up someplace else. It's cool.
You're overcharging.
Let's be honest. You don't value what I do. It doesn't matter what price I charge. You're not going to pay it. I'm not losing a customer. You never would have been one in the first place. So no, I don't set my prices for people that don't value me.
And neither should you.
Here's another cake decorating video, and speaking of me saying that, someone pointed out that I say that at the beginning of, like, all of my cake decorating videos, and I never realized that, but, that's awkward. Okay, anyways, so this is another order, and surprisingly, this wasn't someone on TikTok. Some people have asked me, like, do I have a business or whatever. I don't call it a business, but even before TikTok, I had a side hustle of baking. Freshman year, I made probably $400, $500 in, like, 2 months. Which is great and all, but everyone, like, paid me in ones, and for some reason, I would carry that around in a Ziploc bag in my backpack, which was probably the dumbest thing I've done before. I mean, probably not the dumbest, but it's up there. So, advice for you rising freshmen, don't carry around all your money in a Ziploc bag in your backpack, because that's pretty fucking stupid. But thankfully, I never got robbed, and yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, bye! Hi guys, here's another cake decorating video, and this cake is literally my favorite cake I've ever made. Like, it's so good. Like, first of all, there's cookie dough inside, which is delicious, and then Oreo buttercream. I fucking love Oreo. And people always tell me to make, like, Oreo-type desserts, and usually I can't because if I have certain foods, I just can't have in the house because I will eat them all. Like, I cannot have Pop-Tarts or Oreos or Cinnamon Toast Crunch in the house because I will demolish the entire box by myself in a matter of a day or two. But for the stripes, I was honestly just too lazy to fill a bunch of piping bags, and I didn't want to waste them, so that's why I did it like this, but I gave up for the red. But yeah, I know I could use a piping bag, I just didn't feel like it. But for real, can I just flex how cool these stripes are? Like, oh my god, it's just amazing. Like, the contrast, like the Oreo and the colors, like, I don't usually say this, but I'm so proud of this cake. I also may or may not have eaten a lot of Oreos in the process of making this cake. But it's fine, it was worth it, and yeah, that's it, thanks for watching, bye!
Hello loves! Okay, this is my second cocoa melon cake that I've ever made. I honestly have never heard of it. My first time was on TikTok and when a customer requested it. And if you scroll back on my videos a little bit, my first cocoa melon cake is on there, but it's not like this. It's just in the shape of a regular cake. This one, she actually wanted it in the shape of the cocoa melon design, which I was like excited to do because this was my first time. Anytime I do a cake like for the first time, I get excited. Anytime I do a cake for like the 100th time, I'm like, all right, it's another Mickey Mouse cake. No, which I won't say no to. And it's not like I don't enjoy it. It's just kind of like, okay, been there, done that. So making this one was exciting. If you ask me to do it again, I might be like, all right, I guess I got to. But anyways, it turned out so adorable. I really, really do love it. I included the little ladybug. If you want to know how I made that, I actually have a video prior. And here's the result. It's so cute.
DIY surprise cake part 2. To figure out exactly how big I needed to make the hole in the cake, I used an extra box to put an indent so that I could cut it out. And using a long skinny knife, I very carefully cut out the middle square with the help of my friend Sarah, who held the cake in place for me. Using a spatula on either side, I lifted out the center section and saved it to eat later. To keep the box in place, I applied hot glue to each of the corners and in the middle, and then I stuck it down to the plate at the bottom of the cake box. I also taped the back of the Spider-Man candle to the last dollar sticking out so that I could place it on top of the cake and it would be connected to the dollar. When the topper is pulled out, it will pull the money out of the box. For the last step, I replaced the top part of the cake to fill in the rest above the box, and then I'm going to be putting some cream cheese icing over to conceal the little hidden compartment. Here's the finished result. Come back tomorrow to see his reaction when we cut it.
Max and Ruby, Ruby and Max.
In part 3, my cakes are done and we're going to stack them together. So I glue it with a little bit of melted white chocolate. You're going to insert a dowel, use a Sharpie because it's non-toxic, to make a mark at the very top. We'll line them all up, put a ruler across, and make that same mark so everyone is the same size. We'll cut them all with a dowel cutter. What I normally do is whatever size tier is above, which is a 5-inch, I put 5 dowels. So if you had a 6, you put 6, a 7, 7, and so on. A little bit of buttercream, add it to the top, make sure everything is nice and smooth, and then I'm going to take and add a dowel all the way down that's sharpened, because I am delivering this. I don't trust the roads. And then I'm gonna take buttercream and sort of seal everything together. Now we're gonna get back in the cooler and make our decorations. This is a white chocolate ganache that I added a little bit of green and peppermint oil to. So then we have chocolate and we have mint. And I'm gonna dip a bunch of cones because this is for a 13-year-old boy and I want it to be really fun and exciting because his birthday is on Christmas and he probably gets overshadowed by, I don't know, Jesus. So we're gonna make him something really special.
Hate bad about it, hate bad about it. Niggas know I had to swing, I had to make a play. I had to apply the pressure, cause you my hidden treasure. I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love?
I tell you everything.
I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want.
Go ahead.
You get what you please. We bout to get it on. Take off them drawers. It's just you and me. You know what I be on.
Could be red, or I could be yellow, I could be blue, or I could be purple, I could be green or pink or black or white, I could be every color you like. I could be red, or I could be yellow, I could be blue, or I could be purple, I could be green or pink or black or white, I could be every color you like. I could be red, or I could be yellow, I could be blue, or I could be purple, I could be green or pink or black or white, I could be every color you like.
On my
crack it open.
This literally happened the worst way. You're supposed to cut it open. No. You cut it the worst ever. You literally were supposed to cut it a little bit and crack it open so that it pours out.
That just doesn't look good.
And they told me I don't need to worry. Summer came like cinnamon, so sweet. Little girls double dutch on the concrete. Maybe sometimes we got it wrong, but it's alright. The more things seem to change, the same, don't you hesitate. Girl, put your records on. Tell me your favorite song. Yeah, girl.
Hey guys, here's a cake I made last week before I went on my trip. It was a chocolate cake with chocolate buttercream. This one seems to be one of my most popular orders, and I don't blame them because chocolate cake is my favorite. I also wanted to say thank you to everyone who follows me and supports me. I finally reached my goal of getting 100,000 followers, and I actually hit it a couple months early. I had a goal for myself in December that I wanted 100,000 followers, so when I saw that I got it over this past weekend, I was so excited and so happy, and I just couldn't believe it. A couple videos back, I mentioned how once I hit 100,000 followers, I would make a course for you guys. So if you guys could leave a comment letting me know what kind of things you want to learn, that'd be awesome. And then I'll get the course started for you guys. Thanks so much to everyone who's following along, and I hope you guys all have a great week.
This is a sign to go make a cake with your cousin. First layer. Add frosting and strawberries. Second layer. Frosting. Sprinkles. Strawberries. Chef's kiss.
Hi guys, here's another cake decorating video, and can I start off by saying, can y'all like not be mean to me? Like, I know that people are gonna, or people always will say shit like, oh, if you're a creator, if you make content, you have to expect hate, like you can't get mad about it, whatever. But like, I'm sensitive, y'all. You tell me my cakes look like shit, yeah, it's gonna hurt my feelings. But that being said, all y'all leaving mean comments, I hope you know the algorithm can't tell if your comment is mean or nice, so either way, thanks. But anyways, I don't really have a story to talk about today because my life is actually pretty fucking boring. But I put gas into my car for the first time last week, so that was fun. And that literally happened a week ago, and that's the most exciting thing I have to talk about. But it was cool, like, it was kind of scary. I kept thinking I was gonna get blown up by the gas or something. And, like, apparently if you use your phone, that can, like, make it blow up or, I don't know, it was scary. But, like, it was a fun experience, I guess. But, oh, shit, I'm out of time. Okay, yeah, thanks for watching, bye.
Here it is. This is the top of my wedding cake.
Okay, it's not a wedding cake, but I've had a piece of cake that I've had since the little day I was born. And I've been waiting so long to show you guys.